Hi everyone, welcome back to our math channel, Math Bridges, Fun with Math. Today I have come up with an interesting topic. It's about zero. What comes onto your mind when I say about zero? Is it a numerical digit or a number? Zero is both a number and a numerical digit. It is used to represent the number in numerals. When I ask you what zero exactly is, many of the people, they think zero to be as nothing. Zero means nothing, they will say. But it is not nothing. Zero means it is absence of some quantity is zero. Now let's get into the topic and see in detail. 1 divided by 0 is how much? So today our topic is division of a number by 0. What 0 is? What exactly zero is? It is our Indian mathematicians of ancient India who really came up with a concrete and comprehensive meaning of zero as a concept, as a digit, as a limit, and as a nullity. So let's see what is the answer for 1 divided by 0. If you ask the question, 1 divided by 0 is undefined. Is it true or false? Some people say it's true because dividing by zero is not allowed. And some people say it's as false and they'll consider 1 by 0 to be as infinity. So which one is correct? Is it undefined or is it infinity? So let's see what exactly it is. The great Indian mathematician and astronomer Aryabhatta invented zero. He gave the world zero for which he became immortal. He was the first one to use zero to define the decimal system. Without zero, the world would never move forward. He did not use zero, but he used it to be as a symbol. Later, after Aryabhatta, it is the great mathematician Brahmagupta who used zero as a number. He gave the rules to compute with zero. He was the first mathematician to use zero as a number. Brahmagupta was the one who started working with zero as a separate number and tried to define operations using zero. Let's see what are the rules he has given. The first one, 1 plus 0 is 1. Next one, 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 into 0 is 0. And the next one is 1 divided by 0 is how much? Division by 0, any number divided by 0, he was not able to give the justification for this rule. Later, Bhaskara II, a great mathematician who came up with the first explanation of what division by 0 is. He has mentioned this one in his book Lilavati. He has given the conclusion 1 divided by 0 is infinity, means 1 by 0 equals to infinity. How he has given the justification, let's see with some examples. Let's see one example. 10 apples are to be shared equally among two friends, Reena and Sonu. So when you are dividing 10 apples among two friends, each person will be getting 5 apples. It's very clear that is 10 divided by 2 is equals to 5. Here, 6 apples are to be shared equally among 0 friends. 6 apples you are sharing among 0 friends. 0 friends means it is absence of quantity called friends. There are no friends available over here, but we have to share 6 apples among them. Will it be possible when the friends are not available? So what will be the answer for 6 divided by 0? When you are not in a position to divide to 0 people, it is absence of quantity, isn't it? So 6 divided by 0, we can consider it to be as undefined, which is not possible. For the mathematician Bhaskara, he has defined 1 by 0 to be as infinity. Let's see with the same 10 apples how it has come. So 10 apples are to be divided among 5 people. So each person will get 2 apples. The same 10 apples, if you are dividing among 2 people, each person will get 5 apples. If it has to be divided among only one person, he'll be getting 10 apples. You observe here, as the denominator is decreasing, the first one 5, next it is 2, and the next it is 1. As the denominator is decreasing, the value, the answer value is increasing. It is 2, 5, and 10. So if I'm taking one more time, 10 divided by half, it will be 20. 10 divided by 1 by 4, it will be 40. So as I keep on decreasing the denominator, the answer value is increasing. So let's take now 10 divided by 0. It should be a very, very big number. So what will be that number? We can't predict. So it will be a bigger number that automatically approaches to infinity. This was the fact which was given by great mathematician Bhaskara. So we got 10 divided by 0 as infinity. So we have checked with if 10 apples are divided among 2 people, we'll get the answer as 5. 10 divided by 5, we'll get the answer as 2. When 10 is divided by 0, we are getting it to be as infinity. So let's check. We'll cross multiply this one. 0 into infinity is 10. But as we know, 0 when it is multiplied by any number, it will be 0 itself. So 0 is equals to 10. Is it true? Is 0 is equals to 10? If I consider in the same manner, in place of 10, if I am taking 4 apples or 46 apples, 138 apples or 265 apples divided by 0, I can prove that 0 is equals to 1, 0 is equals to 2, 0 equals to 46, and 0 can be equal to any number, which is absolutely wrong, isn't it? So if it happens, what will happen? The complete, the number line system, it will collapse. See here, 0 is there. If 0 equals to 1, the 1 it will fall over here, 2 also, 3 also, any number, everything it will fall and the number line system will collapse. So we can't do any of the operations. So 1 by 0 is equals to infinity is not true. Before, we have seen using division method, any number divided by 0 is not defined. Now let us see using multiplicative inverse method. Let us consider example a number 3. The multiplicative inverse of 3 is 1 by 3. 3 and 3 get cancelled, we'll get it as 1 answer. Now consider one more number 5. Multiplicative inverse of 5 is 1 by 5. 5 and 5 get cancelled, it is 1. Now let's take 0. So multiplicative inverse of 0 will be 1 by 0. 0, 0 get cancelled. Answer should be 1. But if you observe 0 into any number, what will be the answer? It should be 0. But we are considering it to be as 1. So let's see whether it's true or false. We got it as 0 into 1 by 0 is 1. As per the previous discussion, 1 by 0 is equals to infinity we have considered. So 0 into infinity is 1. Now I'll add this same equation twice. 0 into infinity plus 0 into infinity means 1 plus 1, it should be 2. Now by using the distributive property, I'm writing 0 plus 0 into infinity is 2. 0 plus 0 is 0 and infinity as it is I'm writing, which is equals to 2. But what is 0 into infinity here? It's given to be as 1. So 1 equals to 2. Is 1 equal to 2? Is it true? No, it's absolutely wrong, right? So by using this method also, it has been ruled out that 1 divided by 0, it is not defined, it's undefined. We all know division is just the opposite of multiplication. Now let us try to prove any number divided by 0 is undefined using this method. Let's take an example. 8 divided by 2 is how much? What does it mean? It means 2 into some number, if you are multiplying, we'll get the answer as 8. So 2 into how much is 8? It is 4. So the answer is 4. Consider 6 divided by 0. So 6 divided by 0 is how much? It means 0 into some number, when we are doing, we must get 6. So 0 into how much? Let's decide 0 table. 0 ones are 0. So 0 times 2 is 0. 0 times 9 is 0. 0 times 10 is 0, 0 times 657 is 0. Any number if you are taking and multiplying, we'll get the product as 0 itself. But we don't get 6 as the product, isn't it? So, 6 divided by 0 is undefined because you don't get the answer over here. 0 into how much? By which number when we are multiplying do we get 6? Does it exist? Can we define that number? No. So 6 divided by 0 is undefined. You can consider this example by using multiplication method also. We have proved that when we are trying to divide a number by 0, we get it to be as undefined. Now, we will take an example dividing a number by 0. 12 divided by 0 is how much? So 0 into how much will be 12? It means. So how much it is? 0 into how much? You can recite 0 table again. 0 ones are 0. 0 times 7 is 0. 0 times 9 is 0. 0 times 12 is 0. Any number you can consider 0 times 657 is 0. But do you get 12 over here? No. Isn't it? So 12 divided by 0 is undefined. You can't define it. It's very weird, isn't it? So any number divided by 0 is always undefined. Now, let's prove it based on algebra. Why division by 0 is not allowed? We'll consider A equals to B where A comma B is greater than 0 and we have to prove 1 equals to 2. We'll take what has been given, A equals to B, and we'll multiply with B on both the sides. So it becomes AB equals to B square. Now subtract A square on both the sides. So it is AB minus A square equals to B square minus A square. If you observe here, this is in the form of B minus A into B plus A, A square minus B square formula. Here I will take A as common. A into B minus A equals to B plus A into B minus A. Now A equals to, this as it is we will write B plus A into B minus A, and B minus A will come in the denominator. Now same like terms is we'll cancel B minus A and B minus A. So we got it as A equals to B plus A. But we know it's given as A is equals to B. So we will substitute the value of B. Means we'll write it A over here now. A equals to A plus A as both are equal. A equals to 2A. That means 1 is equals to 2. Is it true? Let's see. We got it as 1 is equals to 2. Now we subtract 1 on both the sides. So 1 minus 1 equals to 2 minus 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0 and 2 minus 1 is 1. 0 equals to 1. Is it true? No. Now let's continue. Multiply with 10 on both the sides. So it is 10 into 0 equals to 10 into 1. So 10 zeros are 0 and 10 ones are 10. So we have proved 0 is equals to 10. Which is absolutely wrong, and really if it happens again, the complete the number system will collapse. Zero fulfills a central role in mathematics as addition identity, real numbers, algebraic structures and many more. If you are trying to divide a number by zero, the complete mathematical system will be collapsing. Now let's see one special case, that is 0 divided by 0 is how much? We consider the same method. 0 into how much is 0. That means we'll recite 0 table and see which number we'll get it over here. 0 times 1 is 0. 0 times 2 is 0. 0 times 15 is 0. 0 times 46 is 0. So which number can be considered as the answer? Is it 1? Is it 2? Is it 15? 46? 300? 2000? Or 1 lakh? Which number will be the answer? Each person will get different answer. They may consider 15, they may consider 28. One may consider to be as 496. We'll get many answers, isn't it? So many numbers. So on it continues. 0 into 15 is 0. 0 into 38 is 0. 0 into 792 is 0. So it keep on continuing. That's why we say 0 divided by 0 is indeterminate. What is the meaning of this indeterminate? It means it is not established. The answer is not exactly known. or it could be of any value. Any value means it may be 3, 15. It differs from one person to person, the answer. So that's why when we are getting the case as 0 divided by 0, we will consider it to be as indeterminate. In the real life situation, you take your calculator, which is in your mobile or your laptop. You give it as 1 divided by 0 and check what will be the answer. You will see it to be as it cannot be divided by 0. If you observe here, 1 divided by 0, in some of the calculators, it will be showing it to be as cannot divide by 0, means which is undefined. If you are giving 0 divided by 0, here you can see 0 divided by 0, this operation, the result will be undefined, or we can say it to be as indeterminate, means which does not have any value or which the value has not been established. Let's recap what we have learned today. First one, when something other than 0 is divided by 0, the result is undefined. Like for example, when 3 is divided by 0, the answer is undefined. It may be 8 divided by 0, 28 by 0, 136 by 0, any number when we are dividing by 0, it is undefined. And in case 2, we have seen when 0 is divided by 0, the result is indeterminate, means it is not established, the value is not known. So 0 divided by 0 is indeterminate. A easy way to remember when we are dividing a number by 0, remember the word n or no. N on the numerator, number by 0. Any number means n divided by 0, it is undefined, which is not possible. So it's saying no, it's not possible. Don't divide a number by 0. You have seen when we are dividing, it's in multiplication, it's in division, it's in algebra, it's any of the system you can take mathematical concepts, completely the system collapses. So, better not to divide by 0. I give you a real life example. When a number has been divided by 0, what will happen? This is USS Yorktown CG-48, a warship, which is a smart ship which completely operates on the computer and the database system. In this USS Yorktown CG-48 warship, one of the technicians, he tried to digitally calibrate and reset the fuel value by entering a zero value for one of its component properties into the remote database manager. When he tried to perform the operation division by zero, immediately the complete networking system and the RDM has been crashed and the ship has to halt for more than a day on the sea itself. So, when we are trying to do the operations which is undefined, we'll be facing problems in real life too. Let's consider one more real life situation as an example. We'll consider trigonometry as a topic over here. When we place a ladder against a tall building, here you can observe in the picture, if you try dividing by zero in this case, the ladder is flat against the wall. So when you climb, you will definitely topple over backwards. So when you are trying to divide by zero, definitely it will collapse. We have seen in today's video, when any number divided by zero, it is undefined, and when zero is divided by zero, it is indeterminate. Zero is a strange number and one of the greatest paradoxes of human thought. It means both the absence of quantity and also everything. Do you all know what does zero mean in texting? It means surprise. We'll be doing texting in WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter and so on. The definition, it means surprise. All the emoticons or the emojis what we are using, it is based on the digit zero. Using the codes, they'll be converting this 00 using the digit code 00. These emojis have been created. Such an amazing fact, isn't it? That's why zero is known as king of the numbers. It will be used in many ways. Thank you for watching my video. Like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you everyone.